going on, everyone? I'm the Nihon Guy. This is Sonic Adventure DX. And last time I finished Sonic's campaign, this time I figured, let's get the worst out of the way. Big the Cat. Let's go. So, yeah, a lot of people don't like Big the Cat at all. And I see where they're coming from. As a character, I do like him. He's just a slow-witted muscle man of sorts. Like, imagine those dumb hulking henchmen that are usually on the bad guy's side, but he's a good guy. But with that being said, I do gotta say that Big the Cat is not a character I ever felt that had any purpose whatsoever. I feel like Sega created him and just wanted to put him in the game and nothing else. They had no plans for him. Chase a frog.
Yoo-hoo, froggy. Come out, wherever you are. Oh man, where could that polywog pal be anyway?
Normally you would talk to people and
somewhere in the city where you can go down.
Big the Cat is incredibly slow. But in later games, you can run pretty fast. So, don't understand that logic. So much they can do with that, but they never did. Huh? So much wasted potential in this character. But hey, at least he has a small career in being a background character, and occasionally a playable character in third-party games. So, in that sense, he's kind of the Waluigi of Sonic. Huh? Did I piss off Waluigi fans by saying that? And I also just like to acknowledge that you can sneak into this park.
Welcome to Twinkle Park.
Via the sewer. I don't know. Anyway, Big the Cat's game is fishing. Yeah, fishing in a Sonic game. fair, Sega had made quite a few fishing games. I never quite understood how to fish in this game. Like, all I'm really doing is moving the stick left and right and just kind of hoping that I catch it. I do like the music that plays as you're catching the fish.
Bad.
I'm gonna see if I can fit in the Bitcat story all in one go, at the risk of making a longer video. I kinda don't wanna come back to this. Jeez, what's wrong with his arms?
Welcome to Twinkle Park.
Sorry, that was way more entertaining than the actual gameplay of Bitcat. Free! Hey! I'll see you in Sonic Heroes! Carries money around with him. up here. Go to ice caps down here. Sonic, Tails, and Big the Cat all get the ice cube. Is like someone taking it and just throwing it at random places? It seems like Big the Cat gets it first, at least. Notation builds.
Discovered the life belt. It keeps you afloat when you're in water. To swim underwater, press the jump button when afloat.
Which is very helpful in Big the Cat's game. And I can just hold the jump button to go underwater if I want to. Because some areas of Big the Cat's stage have like 1-ups and stuff, but you don't really need them. Thankfully, a lot of areas you can just walk out of. Ice cap zone. Froggy has somehow made his way all the way to the Arctic and is swimming under sub-zero waters that even warm-blooded creatures can't survive in. Come on, except the rock. Yep, there he is. Just swimming in ice-cold water that most frogs would die in.
Ooh.
that I found you. Oops. Oh, now what am I gonna do?
If I didn't have
a lot of tails
at this point, I would have a lot of tails. Hey, little buddy. And normally I'm supposed to chase him towards the train station, but I think real quick. Gonna go back to Vic's house. Cast your rod, father. Yay! Thank you. I don't get why can't. He's like right here. Why can't you just grab him? Why do I have to fish him for him?
Froggy?
Uh-oh. Well, now he can run a bit faster.
No! Hold on there! Come back, please! Give me my friend back! I'm begging you, please!
Oh, by the way, Big, you can lift a car over your head. You can turn that robot in half. He's just a nice guy, I guess.
Around somewhere. Let's go see what's behind this door.
Apparently, he's still frogging through all this machinery. Hot shelter, bitch, you got glass cage. Get out of the water.
this, Scotty? Looks like you need my help.
So that's the fish tank. They can just empty into this floor here. I don't understand this one.
Something's biting!
See, it worked that time. It didn't work in the ice caps though.
Doggy!
Lousy picky game.
Not too bad.
Hey, so happy with yourself.
We're together again at last, huh?
And then the call comes in, and it shows Big the Cat some of the past.
Huh? That's
she does this with all the characters in the game, by the way, but it makes no sense in context. Like, as a player, I know what's going on, but why do they need to see this? Also, why wasn't the frog transferred?
Where am I?
I question that even when I was a teenager. Wait, do I need to go this way? I actually don't remember. Okay, yeah. There's the call. There's the call. And I'll hear adorable kitten in this.
Wow.
The water says yes.
Is it all right for me to be here? So do you trust me? The 7 emeralds.
And he's still holding the frog. He got out. I guess he was teleported.
Froggy? I don't like the looks of this place. If something happens now, there's no point to my rescuing you.
Maybe a blue hedgehog.
I don't know who would bother to save us both. We better get going, buddy!
Emergency alert has been canceled. Resuming monorail operations.
You wouldn't even know that this monorail's here without being the cat, because you don't need it in every other case. Let's finish up Big Cat's story. Now he's outside. He's got to do his final boss. And going all the way up here. Going all the way in here.
Three,
one's rate go higher than the other. That makes no damn sense. Unless the sprite's just like hitting and blow there or something. Anyway.
I see you're trying to escape. I'm right on time. Chaos, grab him. Get that frog. And don't forget the Chaos Emerald.
So yeah, Bitcat's entire story is chasing this frog. And the frog has more significance to the plot than being the cat. For one of the most confusing things I've ever seen from Bit to Cat.
What? Hey, maybe we could use this. But I don't know the first thing about it. Oh well, I'll give it a try anyway.
And in a few seconds, learns to Politeos' plan. Like, he just flies off with it, no problem. A recurring thing, actually. Like, Big somehow manages to pilot all kinds of mechs and machineries throughout this franchise. Anyway, that's Big the Cat's story. Wasn't that riveting? I can't lie, the Louisianian in me, kind of likes the theme song. Yeah, that's it. I don't really know what else to say. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sticking through to it. I know a lot of people don't like Big the Cat. If you watch this far, again, you are a trooper.
It's a windy and sunny day.
Because this story has very little significance to everything in this game. Next time, I will play as Miles Tells Prower. So be sure to come back and see that.
Every day's a new beginning.
Sorry, I'm very distracted by this song. But, yeah, when Tells is gameplay, Gracious Sonic and Dr. Eggman through a few stages. And a lot more fun than this. So, trying to find words. Pictures are actually kind of hilarious to me because Big has less gameplay than any other character and less cutscenes. So I want you to imagine that Sonic Team was just like, how do we make this interesting? Maybe Big the Cat stand by two girls in swimsuits.
Sorry, but I don't know we are.
Because we have nothing to work with.
We present you with a gift. Welcome to our paradise.
I did his entire campaign in one episode.
Hey!
Like, a little over 30 minutes, I think. He caught a fish.
What you think about the incident? You were wasted before granted. I am asking you as a first step.
Again, this was just like random shots.
Hey, big guy, hey, little guy, can you tell me who came first? Sorry, but I don't know. We are simply natural. Okay, all you have to do is sit up good, left, right, up, and down. Hey, big guy, hey, little guy, can you tell me what's inside? Sorry, but I don't know.
I'll catch you guys next time. See ya, Johnny.
Thanks for watching till the end. Be sure to subscribe and I'll see you again. Check me out on Twitter and Instagram, where you can see me do all kinds of dumb stuff.